Hello my dear students, welcome back. Today I am here with a new topic from your chapter. Hope all of you are safe, healthy and happy. Yes, today I am going to discuss a very important topic from your syllabus, which is having a link to our life. So what is the topic? Already I have done the board work, you are getting to see. The topic of discussion is today that disaster. Yes, disaster. The term it might have also you have heard somewhere. It is having a great link to our life. So today we are going to know about disaster. So be focused, keep learning and stay with me to see all that parts whatever we are going to discuss. So very first I will tell that what point we are going to discuss. First point is definition of disaster. Next is type of disaster, then hazards, then importance of disaster management. So today I will cover up these four points. Okay. So first I am starting with the definition. Yes, student. Whenever the topic is disasters, so we have to know the definition of disaster. So what is the definition? It is, we can say that very is sudden, a sudden and unexpected occurrence of that event or any of the incident which is causing that damage, massive damage, even rampant that damage of our lives and properties. That is caused that dam also disaster. Okay, so we easily can say the disaster means which is causing that proper loss of lives and property. So students, so what we have understood, what is the definition of disaster? In easy language we can say that due to that also any of that unexpected event when we lost our lives and property, that is known as disaster. Okay, so here next point we are going to know. First point we have done, second point, types of disaster. Types disaster can be either that natural or man-made. So here I already have done the types of disasters: natural disaster, man-made disaster. Natural means the disaster which is causing by that the factors of the nature or geographical factors. Here see that earthquake, flood, cyclone, drought, even that we can also add that forest fire. We can also add forest fire, that also is that also natural that disaster. Why it is a natural disaster? We all know this kind of disaster we usually heard and seen in different parts of our country. Very recently that from middle of month of May till now, it means June 10, we have seen in the part of NCR near about 12 that earthquake, that is minor earthquake, we have experienced or felt. Okay, so here that these are the minors. Why? Because these were not destructive. We will get to know later on about that earthquake, but yes, according to the natural activist, according to the geologist or scientist, it is said that the earth is releasing its pressure. Due to that that we are in safe hand and we will not face any that massive that kind of that earthquake country at the northern India. Okay, so here earthquake, due to that earthquake that destruction can be there, due to that life loss, even also not only that crumbling of roads, bridges, that building collapse, and so many that damages and destruction usefully that we have seen in different parts of our country and different parts of the world. And it is a natural that disaster. Then floods. Yes, flood, you have seen that due to the flood that also different parts of that world, even mainly in our country, very recently part of Himachal Pradesh, some also Himachal Pradesh, where due to heavy rainfall people face that stop. Okay, next is cyclones. It is another very recent incident you might have seen at the part of where West Bengal and Odisha. Very recently Amphan or Ampon and also a cyclone which formed over Bay of Bengal at the eastern coast of India. Eastern coast here, that is Bay of Bengal. You know, So here Odisha and here West Bengal. These two also state they have suffered a lot because over Bay of Bengal a low pressure zone formed, and due to that a cyclones which also named as Amphan that is also damaged Odisha and West Bengal part, and due to that loss of lives and property damages were there. It is very recent that incident you might have heard and read in an oral seen in that newspapers and TV news everywhere. Now next is drought. Due to lack of water, or we can say acute water shortage condition that causes drought. In an arid region where there is very less rainfall, there we can see drought condition. Next is there forest fire. That is natural due to scorching heat of the sun. Sometimes the dry leaves, dry stems, it can fire up. What is happening in different parts of India, you might have seen just some days before at that also Himachal Pradesh part it is happening also, and so that miles of area totally it burned, and every year this is happening due to that scorching heat, and it is also caused by man-made, that is another part we will talk about. So these are the natural that disaster which is causing that damage of life and that also what we can say that lives and property. Okay, now students we will get to know man-made disaster. Man-made means which is causing by the human being or human being like us. Like when people become irresponsible, their casual behavior, sometime also due to lack of awareness, concern is that we are facing that different kind of disaster. Like very recently you heard about that Vizag, that nuclear that power plant having that also the leakage of gases, and due to that so many people also dies, even the surrounding areas atmosphere totally become poisonous. Okay, and here see some also has disaster I have given are written fires. Due to that our also lack of awareness, irresponsibility, sometime we forget to that switch off the lights, even to off the ovens of that gas, that due to that the fire also causes and we lose our lives, and sometime whole building, whole house it also burned up. Yeah, okay. Next, industrial accident. Yes, nearby also any of the industries which also it is it means their effluence, that effluence it can cause the damage of the soil, damage of the environment, even damage of the life. Okay, or loss of the life we have seen in different parts because some poisonous chemical is released which is not good for our health. Terrorism, that you know, sudden unexpected terrorist attack. It is given also keeping that atomic also bomb in that car, in that parking place, in that dustbins, in some of the areas, and suddenly due to that the property losses and people, so many innocent people, they lost their lives. That is a man-made disaster which is totally against the humanity. Yes, it we should not that favor this kind of people. Yes, next is travel related accident. Accident everywhere, you might have seen in the newspapers every day how many deaths are there in our country. Maximum death is happening due to that road accidents. It can be that road accidents, it can be that train accident, it can be that what airplane that crashes. Yes, due to that so many people they are losing their lives. These are the different disasters I have discussed today. So natural and man-made disaster, hope you have understood today. So see here I have covered the second point also. Now we are going to know third point, hazard. What is hazard? Hazard means the condition which is causing disaster. It means that the situation already available there, and due to that the disaster is happening. So you are thinking, how what is the difference between that hazard and disaster? Yes, disaster the cause, it means disaster the result, and cause is the hazard. Like I am giving the example, like the people who are living nearby a river bank. Riverbank is the hazard, and due to that it is causing the flood. When due to that also heavy rainfall in the river, the over flooding condition is happening, that is disaster also forming. Okay, another also example I am giving, those people are living also nearby any nuclear power plant or any of that petrochemical or any of the chemical industry. Due to that, whatever wastage also they are throwing in the nature, or directly it is mixing in that atmosphere or in the water, that is causing that the problem to the life. So effects we are getting. Okay, another we can say that due to the presence of this power plant, nuclear power plant, that these are the hazards, and whatever the problem happening, that is the disasters. Okay, another we can say those people are living in Japan, they know that the earthquake is a natural phenomenon there, because they are living at that also plate, that germ, it means plate boundaries. It means where the earthquake is very casual. Okay, so here that we can say that the Japan, that the placement of Japan or that area, that is the hazard prone zone, and the disaster they face, the earthquake, tsunami, these are the different that also disaster they are facing. So here I have given some examples of hazards. Okay, so third point we have done. Now we have to know the last most important point, that is importance of disaster management. It is a very recent, that it means very necessary, we can say necessary, that management part, and everywhere in different that also curriculum it has been added, because it is necessary to know how we can take the precautions to cope up with the situation and how to handle the situation. Okay, so what is that disaster management? First we have to know, then we will get to know about importance. So what is disaster management? According to the World Bank, that disaster management is the body of policies and administrative that we can say activities. Okay, so through that we used to take some steps to reduce the suffering and damage after that, damage caused by that disasters. Okay, so here we have to keep in mind disaster management, not only that to look after what damages happened after the disaster. We have disaster management actually, that we can say predict, then also predict of precautions also take, then how to cope up with the situation, then number three, that we can say after the disaster to recover the damage. It means according to the disaster management, first it also give us the awareness, or that it inform us about that also any of that disaster. But all disaster we can't predict all disaster, but some of that disaster we can predict. Like whenever we are talking about cyclones, we know where the low pressure forming, in that case we can predict, or we can say this is anticipated. Okay, so wherever it is also applicable, we can use that predict or precautions, awareness, even you can see that whenever there is any kind of also disaster, it is means it can attack. Before that, government used to also broadcast through that news, through that also radios, televisions, and through that internet, so that people can aware or they can be concerned about that, and they can save or they can move from that place to another place. Okay. Next, scope of the situation. If the problem is sudden come, unexpectedly, then how we will handle that? So, like that, if there is earthquake, what we should do that time? We should then and there drop and cover up our head, and then we should hold on. It means that then and there, how we will save our life, that we should know. Okay. Next is there. To recover the damage after that also, it means disaster, whatever the damage and destruction will be there, that is also we can say it is putting a great that also unexpected expenditure on that on our life, even on that also economics of the government. If have you ever heard, if that is the disaster will be unexpected, what will happen? A unexpected expenditure will be there, and that will put a great great strain on that economy. Okay, but the main that vulnerable class or the poor class, they suffer a lot. How they suffer? If the poor people, they lost their also houses of property, they are not having enough savings. They can't. They can't recover that all things again. They become homeless. Their life totally, it we can say, destroy. So in that case, whatever possible from the side of government used to do that. Okay, now here we have seen that what are disaster management and what is importance. Obviously, it is very important, because we should know when the disaster can be there, how we can take the precautions and how we can handle, and after that what we should do. Okay, so here students, I have covered this all four points. Hope you have understood this all points. So students, here you have understood, hope you have understood whatever points I have discussed, and please also see the video once again, and stay with me to know more information in the next part of the video, and there I will discuss with more also topic and more information about this chapter. So till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.